Hello, I'm Advocate Nikita Pandit and I will be speaking on the remedies in copyright, and you're watching Legal Bites. The main objective of this video is to understand which remedies are available to the copyright owners against the infringement of their copyright works as per the Indian Copyrights Act of 1957 and other laws in India. In case of infringement of copyright, the remedies which are available to the owner of the copyright are civil remedies and criminal remedies. The licensee, having the exclusive right, also has the right to sue in such cases, where the works are published anonymously or with other names, that is pseudonymous works. The publisher also has the right to sue. The case can be initiated by the owner for the remedies like injunction, damages, accounts, or any other remedies as per the law. Now, in case of infringement, the jurisdiction is of the district courts where the plaintiffs or any one of the plaintiffs reside. This is given under Section 62 of the Copyrights Act of 1957. Section 55 provides for civil remedies. First is injunction. Injunction is an order of the court where the court orders a person to do something or to refrain from doing some act. To give injunctive relief or not is the choice of the court. And if the injunction is ordered by the court and the person does not follow the order, it amounts to contempt of court. When the court stops someone from doing some work, it is called restrictive injunction. When the party is ordered to do some act, it is called mandatory injunction. Injunction is perpetual or temporary. Perpetual is permanent injunction. It is usually ordered in the final decree. Temporary injunction is usually during the proceedings till the court issues further orders. This is done to mainly maintain the situation as it is. Now, wherever there is injunction claimed, three elements must be proved. First is, there should be a strong prima facie case. There should be irreparable harm to the party, and it should be such that it cannot be compensated in terms of money. And the balance of convenience should be in favor of the party. Now, there was one case for Mareva injunction, that is Mareva Compania Naviera versus International Bulk Carriers, the Mareva. The Court of England had laid down the principle of Mareva injunction. This is where the party is restrained from disposing the subject matter till the trial or during the proceedings, that is when the judgment is yet to be passed. This was where there was a fear that the defendant would destroy or dispose the subject matter. Whenever the court deems fit, they can order this injunction. Another is Anton Piller KG versus Manufacturing Processes Limited. This is the case of interim injunction when it is applied ex parte, that is Anton Piller injunction. This is an order which is given to enter the premises of the defendant and inspect it. Power is also given to remove such articles if they are found in violation of the law. Now, in such cases, the plaintiff has to show that there is a very strong prima facie case and there is severe damage to the plaintiff if such order is not granted. Evidence is to be given that the defendant possesses some material that is detrimental to the interest of the plaintiff. The court has inherent power to exercise this jurisdiction to direct the plaintiffs to enter the premises of the defendant, to inspect the premises and remove the violative articles. Another is Joel versus various John Doe's, that is John Doe orders. This was the case where the order was sought against unknown persons. This order was for restraining the selling of allegedly violative material when the person doing such acts are unknown. The sale by unauthorized vendor damage the reputation and revenue of the lawful vendors who might be the licensed vendors of the plaintiffs. So, court may order seizing of the goods which are counterfeit goods. Here too, the prerequisites of the injunctions must be proved, after which the court can pass such orders against the unknown persons. Court can also direct the defendants to be present in the hearing even if they themselves are not named. In India, John Doe orders are also known as Ashok Kumar orders. It was first time ordered in the case of Thatch Television versus Ranjan Mandal. This was the case against cable TV operators who telecasted a work without license. Now, these orders are passed by the courts under Section 151 of the Civil Procedure Code, which empowers the court to make any orders that are necessary to ensure justice to the parties and to prevent any power abused by the courts. Order 39 of the Civil Procedure Code provides for the temporary injunction. Court has the power to grant temporary injunction if the property could be destroyed or parted with by any party, or if he threatens that he would remove the property and dispose it to defraud the creditors in order to cause some injury to other party. In civil remedies, if in any work the case is of copyright infringement, the person whose name appears on the work is deemed to be the owner or the author having the copyright. This can be contested by the other party by giving such evidence in the court. The court can also order any party to pay the legal cost of the other party as per the discretion of the court for the hardships which are faced by the other party. Now, in case of multiple copyright owners, each owner has a right to initiate the actions in the court, but it is only to the extent of his own right. The authors of the works are also given moral rights which they can claim for being associated with their work or against their work being distorted or mutilated even after they part with their economic rights. If there is any failure to communicate the work of the author to the public or which is not to the satisfaction of the author is considered as infringement. Now, in case of architectural works, if the structure would infringe the copyright of someone on its completion, the owner of the copyright can get the directions from the court to stop the construction or to demolish it. Now, this clause overrides the provision of the Specific Relief Act. This act also provides that if someone is threatening legal action claiming that he is the owner of the copyright and he would take action, the aggrieved person can approach the court and file a declaratory suit to get a declaration from the court that his acts do not amount to infringement. He can also pray for restraining such threats which are given by another person and also claim damages if he has faced any hardships because of such threats. The infringement of copyright is also a criminal offense, which if there is an intention is found, it is penalized. It attracts a punishment of 6 months to 3 years of imprisonment and fine from 50,000 rupees to 2 lakh rupees as per section 63. For subsequent offense, the minimum punishment is 1 year, which can go up to 3 years, and the fine not less than 1 lakh rupees. The maximum threshold is the same as the first offence. Section 64 has given the power to the police officer, being a sub-inspector or a senior but not of an inferior rank, to confiscate all the infringing material or which may lead to infringement in future without getting any warrant from the court and submit all such material to the magistrate's court. In case any false information is given to the registrar, or if it is made in the register, or if such information is given to cheat the authorities, the penalty is 1 year in prison or fine or both. The jurisdiction in case of criminal case is Metropolitan Magistrate or Judicial Magistrate of First Class. Now, in case of companies that commit such infringement, the person who is in charge can be sued as well as the company in its own capacity. If it is caused by the negligence of any director or key managerial personnel, they can be held personally liable. Chapter 14 of the Act provides for the appeals. Now, in case of criminal offences, the appeal procedure is same as that of other criminal offences as per Criminal Procedure Code, which is to be made within 30 days under Section 71 of the Act. appellate court can be prayed to bring a stay on the execution of the order of the court passing the order. In case of civil appeals, the hierarchy of appeals is as follows. Against the order of the Registrar of Copyrights, the appeal lies to the appellate board within 3 months. Against the order of the appellate board, the appeal lies in High Court where the appellant resides. Some of the cases of infringement and fair use are, first is Zee Telefilms Limited versus Sundial Communications. Now, in this case, infringement suit was filed against Zee Telefilms by Sundial, who had come up with the concept Kanhaiya serial, which consisted of a character Kanhaiya who had super powers of Krishna, the god. They showed this concept to the Zee Telefilms, but they did not hear from Zee Telefilms until they saw the show that Zee telecasted called Krish Kanhaiya. The court held that there were major similarities in the shows, including the character of Kanhaiya and the attributes of his family members and other characters. The court held that there was an infringement as the idea copied was different than the idea of the mythological story which belonged to the plaintiff. It was held that it was colorable imitation. Another case was of Microsoft Corporation versus Satvir Gaur. It was a commercial suit. The defendants were experts in software and IT services in India. Microsoft, Adobe and Quest companies and their subsidiaries in India filed a case against Satvir Gaur for copying and selling their copyrighted software without obtaining lawful license, and this harmed their reputation. The commissioner investigated this matter and the court ordered permanent injunction against the defendants. Another case was KBC Pictures versus AR Margados. Now, this was where the court held it was not a strong case of injunction. This was when it was claimed by the story and the screenplay writer of Tamil movie Gajini that the Hindi movie Gajini had infringed the copyright, and that agreement was not signed by him, and it was a forged agreement and the consideration was not received by him. The Bombay High Court held that the plaintiff could not prove the ownership of his copyright and it was not a strong prima facie case for granting injunction. Now, these are some important provisions related to the remedies under the copyright law in India. Thank you.